As you can see, the numbers were few. Chosen ones to come today to the peaceful protest. And INEC Commissioners. And this is a demonstration of our faith. Within the ambit of the law and within the rule of law, that we must at all times, when we don't agree, make a peaceful protest to either INEC or other organization. We have faith that our laws must work. And that's why we are here. Non-violent, but very peaceful. So we want to put that at number one. Number two, last time we were here, I think the INEC Commissioner represented the chairman. We did the same and submitted our petition. Some changes were made, but not to the satisfaction of the entire country. And today, on this particular occasion, on behalf of the leadership of our party across Nigeria, across all the states, we decided not to come in large numbers so that they don't cause other problems that we may not be able to handle. And that's why we came with the leadership. The secretary is here, and the fellow members of our party. But it is very important for you to note that injustice is being done if it is not tackled and resolved peacefully. It's like a cake of gunpowder being from a pileup that you don't know when it will explode. But we are peaceful, we are law-abiding, we want peace in our country. We have no other country than Nigeria, and we believe in the rule of law. And that's why we're here. So take this peaceful protest very serious. And we're very serious about it. Let it not be well like the usual protest and the usual thing of Nigeria. Do it, nothing will happen after 1 week. It's piling up. And our leaders in our country are not speaking, but it's piling up. One day, God forbid, it can work. Sir, on this protest, we have come to register a protest to INEC of our displeasure on the conduct of 2019, February 24th. The shock. And the shock was not recovered of the amount of the military that was involved in the conduct of that exercise. It has never happened in our country before. It is the first time it's happening. And if it is not checked, it then means that both the security agencies and the military won't be part and parcel of the process of the election. And if we don't come to register protest, there have been several celebrations of awesome, and the entire country, 200 million people, very well, across the nation. If it is not happening almost immediately, that will be another phase of history. We want to also register that as you conduct the affairs of the INEC, historians are recording what is going on. Of course, we read of what happened in 1960, all the elections that took place, and the key actors. Where will the history record INEC as a whole? Are they fear for Nigerians? This is a purely civilian exercise. Then INEC involved the military as if there was war.
And that was the point.
And I can tell you what happened in Bayelsa and in River State. At Bayelsa, the photographer of the personal photographer of the governor was shot by the military. In the River State, the whole local government was sacked. So also in the Amakwa Ibom across the nation, where the security agencies suppress and oppress the people. We have written to the United Nations. We have written to Commonwealth. We have never seen in any part of the world where military are involved in the exercise of election. It is a purely a civilian exercise, and the police are there. My father was a police officer. Police are there to maintain peace and order. You have seen the videos, you have seen the social media of what happened on that day. We want to state clearly going forward. Is that what is going to happen on the 9th? That you will militarize the entire exercise and it's recorded, waiting for another election? We don't need to campaign, we need to state the military and the police, the security agencies. 200 million people. We have come to register and protest the involvement of the military in the exercise of the election by INEC. We have also come to register all parts of the country from the north to the south, the rigging and the manipulations that took place. We have the right to do so. And we are challenging your declaration in the court, so we don't have any problem with that. But moving forward, is that what we are going to do on the 9th? Where the whole state has been earmarked by APC that this state must be taken by force by the military. As a matter of fact, the whole Niger Delta has been declared a state of emergency, taking over. The governors there don't have powers anymore. They can't call commissioners of police. They can't call anybody. The military have taken over. For election that is purely civilian matter. And this is a zone that produces the wealth of the country. You provoke them, you slap them, you don't even allow them to make a choice. Who will lead them? It must be by force. INEC should take note that